Hello, this is NanoDano at DevDungeon.com, and we're going to be looking at working with binary data in Python 3. This is the first video in a playlist of several other videos related to working with binary data in Python 3. Most of these features are not available in Python 2, so you must have Python 3 to follow along. Source code is available on DevDungeon.com for reference. You can check the description for a link. In this video, we're going to look at the Bytes and Bytearray classes. A byte is a data type that consists of 8 bits, bit being a single 0, 1, on-off value. These are the most fundamental building blocks when working with binary data. Let's start by creating some bytes. Let's create a variable named empty bytes and assign it the value of 4 freshly created bytes. So let's type out empty bytes equals bytes parentheses 4. In this case, we're creating 4 bytes. If you want to create more or less, then you can change the number that you provide inside the parentheses. In this case, 4 bytes is the equivalent of 32 bits worth of raw information. Right after we create the empty bytes variable, let's print it out to the console to see what the value is. So print parentheses empty bytes. Let's also print out the type of this variable so we can see what class it is to the Python interpreter. Now, let's run the program and review the output. Okay, we see the first line is B followed by slash 00 repeated 4 times. The B means it's binary data, and the slash X tells you that the numeric value that is about to come is in hexadecimal format. There's 2 numbers per byte. So in this case, there are a series of 4 bytes, each one with a value of 0. On the second line, we can see that the type is a class named bytes. It is important to note that bytes created this way are immutable, which means they cannot be modified in any way after being created. If you have worked with tuples in Python, they are also immutable and cannot be changed. Creating empty bytes with a value of 0 is only so useful. Let's demonstrate how to create some bytes with real values. Let's write data bytes equals bytes parentheses. Now, instead of just passing an integer into the parentheses to tell it how many bytes to create, we want to pass it some actual values. To pass raw binary values, we're going to use hexadecimal notation. It takes the exact same format that we saw output when we printed out the empty bytes. We need to write lowercase b, followed by a single quote to open and a single quote to close to encapsulate the values. Each value is written with the slash x followed by the 2 numbers, just like we saw output earlier. The maximum value for a byte is 255, which translates to FF. So let's create 2 bytes with the highest possible values by putting slash x FF slash x FF in between the quotation marks. If you don't understand hexadecimal notation, I recommend taking a few minutes to do an internet search and see how it works. But the idea is that it is base 16 instead of base 10 that we normally use with the decimal system. Let's also add a print statement to print out the value of our data bytes. Now let's run the program and see how it looks. Okay, now we see the value of our data bytes contains the values we provided instead of just storing 0 like our empty bytes. Creating your bytes this way is much more useful than the first method. Since the byte type is immutable, we must use a different data type if we want to manipulate the data. Python provides the byte array type for this purpose. A byte array behaves just like a regular array, except it contains a series of bytes. I'm going to start a new file for this example. Let's create a byte array. Write mutable bytes equals byte array parentheses. This will create an empty array that can store bytes. Let's also print out the value of our new variable as well as its type. Now let's run the file and see what happens. We see similar output as before, except the array is empty. It doesn't have any bytes in it. We also see that it is of class bytearray. Like the previous examples, we can provide a single integer to the bytearray function, and it will create that number of empty bytes. Let's try 3 and rerun the program. Now we can see that there are 3 bytes in the array, all with the value of 0. Also, like the previous examples, we can provide raw data. Let's pass a few hexadecimal values and rerun the program. As expected, the values match what we provided. Because we are working with a mutable array, we can index and manipulate specific elements. Let's change the value of the first element in the array to 0. When addressing individual elements, we must use the integer decimal notation, so we just pass a 0 instead of the /x00 format we saw earlier. We can also append, pop, push, and do all the other things that you can normally do with an array. Let's try appending another FF or 255 to the end. In this case, we have to write mutable bytes.append 255. 255 is the equivalent of FF in hexadecimal and is the maximum value a single byte can store. Also, like other arrays, we can access a slice or a subset of the array by using the colon notation for the index. For example, let's write print mutable bytes bracket 0 colon 2. This will print the first two elements of the array only. Let's run the program one final time and view the output. The first element of the array should be set to 0, and we should have an extra element of the value FF at the end of the array. That's all we're going to cover in this video. Hopefully you have an understanding of how to create mutable and immutable bytes, as well as modify and access the data. If you have any questions, post a comment or join the Discord server and ask for help. Our Discord server is a growing community of helpful veterans and a place to meet other aspiring beginners. All skill levels are welcome. A link to the Discord server is available in the video description, as well as from the devdungeon.com homepage. Also remember, you can find the full written tutorial about working with binary data in Python on devdungeon.com, and the link is in the description. Thanks for watching.